get over. So I think, sir, most of the things must have been told to you by Anubhav, but there are a few points that I would like to tell you with your permission.
Please.
Sir, this particular case will be there from the side of prosecution, and then defense counsel will come, and both are allotted 1 hour each. So that is maximum time is 1 hour for one side, but that can be extended at your disposal. Secondly, sir, there will be no hearing on quantum of punishment. That means there will be no deliverance of the judgment. Only evaluation has to be there. The minimum marks criteria is 11. Even in the case that the performance of the participant is very poor, 11 marks have to be given. And sir, we have relaxed the rule with respect to dress code, that they may not wear a gown or coat. And sir, mode of competition is English, but in case if any participant is stuck somewhere, so he can use one or two line in Hindi. So that would be all. And sir, the, any reference paper or any paper that a participant referred, suppose the FIR or page number, this, so that is available in soft copy with the registry. So you, even if you want to see any paper, you can just ask the registry, show me paper number this, and it will be visible on the screen.
Very good. I'm having hard copy.
Okay. Sir, wo 11 in one component or 11 in all component, Rupesh sir?
Sir?
11 marks in one component or 11 marks in all the criteria?
One component.
Kitne out of 20. Hai aapke?
Evaluation? Sir, five hain. Five hain, so minimum 11 has to be given in one out of 20.
Okay.
Yes. So, sir, with your permission, can we start the round?
Please.
Registry? Please ask the participants to join.
Yes, sir.
सर इनको गाउन वगैरह इसलिए वो कर दिया क्योंकि ये लोग अपने नेटिव गए हुए हैं तो ये सामान लेके नहीं गए हैं
वेरी राइट वेरी राइट
तो वजह से इनको अलाउ कर दिया कि ये चूंकि इधर उधर जाएंगे सामान लेके आएंगे तो वो ठीक नहीं रहेगा
वेरी राइट और आजकल वैसे भी ये कोविड इज अ ग्रेट प्रॉब्लम
जी 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 सर Registry, kindly seek permission to start the session.
So, shall we start, sir?
Please.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
My Lordship, I'm the public prosecutor for this state for this matter. Without not taking too much time of yours, my Lord, I'd like to brief the facts of this case and later I come on the merits. So, my Lord, the incident was happened on the night of 9 September 2019 near Gitanjali Road when the victim Pankaj Gupta along with his servant, victim number two, Vinod Kumar, after closing his shop like daily, going forwards for their home, three people jumped in front of them and committed robbery.
What was the time of the incident?
My lordship, the time was incident was 10 p.m. of 9 September. So my lordship, I'd like to read the facts of this case. Complainant Pankaj Gupta stated that on 9 September 2019 at around 10 p.m. when he was returning home after closing his shop, along with his servant helper on TVS Jupiter scooty number DL35DP0798, as the complainant reached the near Gitanjali Marg, Malve Nagar, suddenly two unknown persons stopped the complainant's scooty and both person faces were covered with handkerchief and one person was also wearing cap and having knife and complainant and other person having pistol. The person having knife attacked on complainant's left hand and cut injured him, and other person shot the servant and snatched the scooty, gold chain, wristwatch, mobile phone. While doing so, the handkerchief of both the persons got removed and complainant managed to see both the person's faces. After that, both the persons took away the complainant's scooty and ran towards the Holy Chow, Malve Nagar. The complainant told there was whole day sale in the diggy of the scooty, around 1.5 lakhs rupees. The case FI number is 157 was registered on the statement of complainant Pankaj Gupta. And after the registration of the case, then investigation has been entrusted to undersigned. Every effort were made to trace the alleged persons by making local inquiry, checking CCTV footages and tracing the criminals with similar modus operandi and having previous involvement. However, during the course of investigation, the SI Sikandar of the Prashant Vihar informed that the scooty of the complainant in the present case was used by the accused person in the case FIR number 204 and 207. Both under section 397, 307, 326, 34 IPC Prashant Vihar, and same is deposited in the Prashant Vihar, and two accused persons, namely Jahid Khan and Rohit Verma, have been arrested by him in case FIR number 204 and 207. Both have disclosed their involvement in the present case FIR also, that is 157. So my lord, in this case, two accused were involved. First name is Jahid Khan and second name is accused Rohit Verma. Both were arrested on the date of registry police showed to the my lord page number 62 of the NCR. This is the arrest memo of the Rohit Verma. Both were arrested from the court number. Will you please zoom it, registry?
What was the date of arrest?
Sir, date was 3 October 2019. Yeah. Right. And time was 12:15. Yeah. Sir, after knowing the involvement of these accused, IO placed the applications of request for production warrant, application of request for interrogation and arrest, application of request for PC, application for request for TIP. With those requests was declined by the accused. They refused to take the part in the TIP. Then application of request to record 164 statement and application of request to issue NBW. Sir, NBW was issued to the third accused, which is absconding.
Third accused was also involved in the incident?
My lordship?
What was the name of third accused?
Mazhar Sattar.
Mazhar Sattar. He was He was also involved in the incident?
Yes, sir.
So, at the time, in the story of the prosecution, it is mentioned as in the FIR that two persons were involved in the incident. One was carrying knife and other was carrying pistol.
In the statement of 161 of this statement, he improved because he was unconscious that time while he gave the statement to record the
Rukpa. Where is that statement? On which page? 161. And whether it was the statement of complainant or the eyewitness, we know.
Both the statement of.
Both.
So, history, please show the page number 100 of the manual script, of the manual charge sheet, page number 100. So this is the statement of Pankaj Gupta.
Yes. Here he mentioned the name of the other person.
Sir, he not mentioned the name of the other person. The
not other person, but the presence of the other person. What is the relevant portion of that statement?
Rishi, please scroll down and come to the third line. Please scroll down and come to the second, third line. Stop. Please zoom in. Sir, here mention, then they sat on the scooty and ran towards the Holy Chowk, and the boy who was standing with his bike follows them. The two took the scooty and ran away, and the third one is follows them, which was helping them that someone is coming or someone is not.
I see.
The name was disclosed by the Jahid Khan in his disclosure statement. Rishi, please come to the page number.
His name was disclosed as?
Mazhar Sattar,
right.
Yes, sir. In the disclosure statement of Jahid Khan.
All right. Yes.
Let's see, come to the page number 68 of the LCR. So, my lordship, this is the seizure memo, where the police sealed the blood sample and the bullet cap from the crime scene. The ship, please.
This is the page number
68. Yes, sir. Of the LCR.
There is cap of the bullet and blood.
Yes. From the crime scene.
Okay.
Rishi, please come to the page number 69. This is the seizure memo of the bullet and the blood sample which was seized from the hospital. This is the bullet which is from that, the victim second, the eyewitness was shot. And Rishi, please come to the page number 70. Sir, this is the seizure memo of the gun, of the weapon, which was seized from the place of the accused. Sir, 70. Of the LCR. This gun was sealed from the disclosure statement, and under section 27 of the Indian Evidence Act, any recovery made by the, so this is the recovery under section 27 of the Indian Evidence Act. Rishi, please come to the page number 71. So this is the seizure memo of the second weapon, which was a knife.
This is page number
71.
This is page number 20. Scroll down. This is page number 68.
No, sir. Of the LCR is the 71. Of the 68 is the manual strip.
All right. Yes. We should note down is 68 or something. It's 68 here.
Yes, it is.
All right.
We should come to the page number 72. So this is the pointing out memo, which is also prepared, where the gun was seen and knife. Registry, please come to the page number 73. This is the other pointing gun memo, sir, of the gun.
How many is the page number? 70.
Yes.
Income 70.
Please, you tell me the page number which is mentioned on the challan sheet so that it will be convenient for me.
Okay, my lordship.
Yeah. This is page number 70 in my chart sheet.
Yes.
All right.
And registry, now please comes to the page number 126 of the manual script. So this is the ballistic elevation report.
Right.
Registry now comes to page number 127.
This was the page number 126. Yes.
Sir, in page number 127, it is clearly mentioned this was the cap which was sealed from the crime spot. This was the cap of the bullet, and this bullet is used in CZ-75B pistol, and maybe that was used to fire at the victim in the above stated matter. Let's now come to page number 128.
What do you want to say at page number 26? Forensic report.
Sir, this is the detail of this report on page number 127. 126 is the starting of this page,
right,
of this report.
All right.
This is the continuation of this report, sir. Actually, now come to page number 128. Sir, this is the ballistic evaluation report of the bullet which was collected from the hospital. Rishi, please come to the page number 129. The here is clearly mentioned this was the bullet, and this bullet is used in CZ-75B pistol, and maybe that was used to fire at the victim in the above stated matter. Rishi, now come to page number 130.
But the ballistic officer was produced in the court.
Yes, sir. It was also exhibited by PW5. Please scroll down. So it is also exhibited by exhibit PW5/D.
It was exhibited. All right.
Yes. Rishi, please come to page number 130. So this is the ballistic report of the gun, which was seized from the place of the accused, where Rishi comes to page number 131. Sir, in this report is mentioned, this was the weapon that was used to fire at the victim in the above stated matter, and the bullet and the cap of the bullet matches with the pistol. Here it is totally mentioned, sir, ki the bullet and the cap was recovered is matches with this gun.
All right.
Let's now come to page number 132. But this is the forensic report of the knife which was used by the
this
other.
This is page number
132.
Right.
Rishi, come to the page number 133. Sir, here it is clearly mentioned, this was the weapon that was used to injure the victim in the above state matter, and the fingerprints matches with the accused. So, my lordship, due to the due permission of you, I like to read out the section under which they are framed.
Right.
So, my lordship, the section is 397 of the Indian Penal Code. Robbery or dacoity with attempt to cause death or grievous hurt. If at the time of the committing robbery or dacoity, the offender uses any deadly weapon or causes grievous hurt to any person or attempts to cause death, grievous hurt to any person, the imprisonment with which such offender shall be punished shall not be less than 7 years. So, my lordship, if you see the ingredients of this section were duly fulfilled by this charge sheet, the accused with intention uses the deadly weapon and cause grievous hurt to the victim.
Right.
And my lordship, if I come to the second section, the second serious section, this 326. Voluntary causing grievous hurt by dangerous weapons or means. So whoever except in the case provided for by section 335 voluntary causes grievous hurt by means of any instrument for shooting, stabbing or cutting, or any instrument which used as a weapon of offense is likely to cause death or by means of fire or any heated substance or by means of any poison or any corrosive substance or by means of any explosive substance or by means of any substance which it is deleterious to the human body to inhale, to swallow or to receive into the blood or by means of any animal shall be punished with imprisonment for life or with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 10 years and shall also be liable to fine. So, my lordship, if you see, the ingredients of this section was also duly satisfied from this charge sheet.
Why not the 307 was indicted in this matter?
Sir, on the stage of charge on argument, Rishi, please come to the page number 144 of the LCR. Sir, this is the order of the charge on argument. रजिस्ट्री प्लीज शो पेज नंबर 145 नाउ So, my lordship, here the ASJ of that time, Kanika Bhardwaj, in the present matter, stated that I do not find any relevance of 307 of IPC, to which prosecution also agrees to that 307 IPC has no relevance in this present matter.
All right.
So, police charged also them into under 307, but on charge and record stage, the judge discharged that. Charge. Yes. Please come to the page number 21 of the challan. So this is the MLC of the accused of the victim one. Here. It is clearly mentioned, according to this report of the hospital, the victim was brought in the hospital who was in a very grave and dangerous position. The police thought the victim to the brought the victim to the hospital for the treatment of the victim named Pankaj Gupta. According to this report, I, Dr. Ashok Shukla, do hereby certify that the above mentioned victim had a deep cut in his left hand forearm. It was a hopeless situation for him. Due to major blood loss, he almost died. The wound of the victim was treated and it was found that the cut was given by a sharp knife.
Right.
We now come to page number 22.
What the doctor says before the court about this cut? Any question was put by the defense or the prosecution?
Yes, sir. He has come at the PW2 and exhibited the evidence also.
Page number.
Rishik, please show page number 150 of the LCR where statement of Dr. Ashok is given. When the defense counsel asked the doctor, can you tell me the nature of the cut presented of the victim Pankaj Gupta? He answered, the cut was present on the left hand of the victim and it was quite deep cut. It was evident that it was done by a knife. While treating, I gave him 7 stitches. And how deep cut was? It was pretty deep. And if you see this last question, can you state the condition of the Vinod Kumar? He had a gunshot wound on his right shoulder. It looked like that he was shot from near, very near. So it is also exhibited from this PW2 and also stated in this statement also.
What is the page? What is the page number?
150 of this LCR.
I see. Just send the page. Yes.
So this is the statement given by the Dr. Ashok Shukla, which is exhibited as PW2. The question asked by the defense counsel, can you tell me the nature of the cut present on the victim Pankaj Gupta? The cut was present on the left hand of the victim and it was quite deep cut. It was evident that it was done by a knife. While treating, I gave him 7 stitches. The second question was asked, how deep cut was? The answer is pretty deep. And the last question was asked from the defense counsel was, can you state the condition of the Vinod Kumar, that is the second victim and the eyewitness of this case also?
Right.
He had a gunshot wound on his right shoulder. It looked like that he was shot from very near. And the same is in the written on the MLC of the both the victims. So my lordship, this is the clear case of the robbery where accused persons committed the crime of robbery with section 326, voluntary causing grievous hurt. And while they were used the vehicles by using false number plate, section ...482 and 411 were also involved.
Hmm.
And hence, they made a conspiracy for this offense to 120B and 34 also involved. And my lordship, they are using arms like CZ-75B pistol. So section 25, 27, 29 and 35 of the Arms Act also.
Whether prosecution has mentioned any prior meeting of all these accused persons so that with common intention and the conspiracy was held out?
Sir, they have the previous involvement of the cases also.
Earlier than this 157 FIR?
Yes, sir.
What are these FIR?
Sir, in the disclosure statement of the accused Jahid Khan, which was given to the SI Sikandar of the Prashant Vihar, they discloses that they keep on doing this kind of
page
activities.
Number? Page number?
The page number 37 of the challan form.
Page 37. What is it?
With a disclosure statement of the accused Jahid Khan, son of Mehboob Khan, residence of house number 35, B block, Ranjit Nagar, East Delhi. Age 26 years, has stated that I live at the above mentioned address with my family, and because of habit of betting, I am in loss. In order to recover from that loss, I and my friends Rohit Verma, son of Jugail Kishore, residence of house number 287, gully number 3, F block, Ranjit Nagar, East Delhi, and Mazhar Sattar, son of Abdul Sattar, residence of house number 86, block C, Adarsh Nagar, North Delhi, age 27, have decided to commit offenses like that. And yes, me and Rohit were committed the offense in FIR 207, Prashant Vihar, and were also committed the offenses FIR 204, PS Prashant Vihar, and the scooty which the police recovered found robbed on 9-9-2019 from Gitanjali Road, Malvinagar, by shooting and stabbing. And from that date, we are using that scooty, TVS white color scooty Jupiter, and put a false number plate on it, which was DL2M0031. And the second number plate is DL8WH3578. And the passion bike, which we used earlier, it was also a stolen bike. And it was with Mazhar at his place. We can help the police to catch him and tell and cooperate in every manner. and we were committing many offenses earlier also in which investigation is still on and in some status is pending trial and some cases we got bail.
Whether these two FIR 207/19 and 204/19
on page number 23 and page number 27.
All right. What is the date of these two FIR? Whether it was registered, the incident was took place after this incident or
they took place after the date of this incident.
After. Earlier than yes. This 157, there was no FIR.
Sorry, they are not, but there is a record of previous case involvement that is on page number 82 of the manual charge sheet.
I see.
Sir, this is the previous record. Page number 8. FIR, there are two FIR is there and status of the case is pending trial and second is pending investigation and status of the accused is on bail.
Right.
And the second status, second involvement is page number 83. Registry, please come to the page number 83. So this is the criminal record of the other accused.
Other accused means Vinod Kumar, Vinod Verma.
No, sir. Rohit Verma.
I'm sorry.
Sir, Vinod Kumar is the name of the
eyewitness. Yes.
So, sir, if you see, these are the habitual offenders.
Right.
Please come to the page number 108 of the manual challan form. So this is the bail order of the two accused. They are on bail from the date 12 October 2019 till now. They are on bail.
12 October of 19.
Yes, my lord. So, my lord, MLC of both the victims were also exhibited as PW2/A by the Dr. Ashok Shukla. Arrest memo exhibited PW4. PW4 is SI Sikandar Kumar, who is the investigation officer of this case. Seizure memo, bullet cap, sample, bullet and blood sample, gun, knife, these all are exhibited and are on record by the competent prosecution witness. And sir, the FSL and ballistic report also says that the weapons which was recovered from the accused place also matches with the accused, with the fingerprints, and the bullet was shot from the gun which was recovered from the accused Jahid Khan's place.
Okay.
Sir, the Constitution of India gave some rights to its citizens, and under Article 21, right of life is the basic right of fundamental right of the citizens, and right to earn his livelihood is also comes in under right to life. So sir, these people disturbing them and deprive them from not live their life properly. So under acts like Indian Penal Code, these official, these are the offensible offenses, which is 397, 326, 482, 411, 34, 120B, and arms 25, 27, 29, 35 of the arms. So my lordship, my prayer is this, that this charge sheet fulfills the ingredients of these sections, which you also see, and please convict these criminals under these charges. So they do not repeat activities like this.
Right. There are two, three small inquiries. What was the distance of place of incident and the shop of the complainant?
Rishi, please come to the page number 148 of the LCR. This is the statement of Pankaj Gupta.
Page
148.
Statement of Pankaj.
Sir, Learned Defense Council asked this question: what is the distance from your shop to the place of incident? It is around 2 kilometers.
Around 2 kilometers.
So the incident was happened bit. So the incident was held on between the place where complainant goes from that path to his house, and between the path the incident was happened.
At what time he closed the shop? 10 o'clock?
Around 10 o'clock, around.
How much time it will take to reach at the place of incident from the shop? About 5-10 minutes by scooty?
Sir, it is not mentioned here in the statement of this complainant.
If there is no traffic, 2 kilometers can be passed within 10 minutes around.
Might be, my lord. Might be.
Was there any CCTV around?
Sir, there is CCTV, but not where the incident was happened.
It was not catched by the CCTV.
No, sir.
What was the place of recovery?
Sir, recovery of the gun, the weapons.
Weapons as well as the looted article.
Sir, the bullet cap and bullet cap was sealed from the crime spot. And bullet was sealed from the hospital. Where they took from the right shoulder of the victim number 2. Then they handed over to the police. And the gun was sealed from the accused Jahid Khan, and knife was sealed from the accused Rohit Verma.
Right.
where they are also pointing out.
What about looted articles?
So looted articles are 1.5 lakh cash, scooty, iPhone, 7 matte black, wristwatch, and gold chain.
What was recovered?
Sir, only scooty is recovered.
Only scooty. No money recovered?
Sir. No.
No other article?
No. And the scooty is also handed over to the...
Just wait. I'm unable to hear.
Hello. Am I audible, my lord?
Now audible.
So, my lord, the scooty is also handed over.
Again, I am not here.
My lord, am I audible to you?
Now audible.
So, my lord, the scooty is also handed over to the victim also by the magistrate. He moved the...
Only scooty was the recovery.
Yes, sir. Rest of the article is
again, it is not audible. Hello.
Your Honor, I'm audible.
Yes, now audible.
So, you know, the scooty is handed over to the victim. He moved an application for his scooty under the court of magistrate. Rishi, please come to the page number 84 of the manual charge sheet. 84. But this is the application. This is an application for release of vehicle bearing number DL35 DP07 moved on behalf of applicant Shri Pankaj Gupta.
All right. I can understand. Is there any witness of recovery of that scooty? Public witness?
Sir. Sir, they recovered the scooty from the incident, from the crimes spot of the FIR 204. The accused have robbed the scooty from place of FIR 157. Then they keep on using that scooty to loot, to commit other crimes.
Whether it was found abandoned or it was recovered from the possession of some accused?
They found abandoned. They left the scooty from the crime scene of the FIR 204. And SI Sikandar found that scooty. And with the chase number, they found that this scooty is also stolen.
What was that place?
सर कादंबरी रोड कादंबरी रोड इज द एरिया कम्स अंडर प्रशांत
विहार प्रशांत प्रशांत विहार
यस सर So the jurisdiction of the two Marvelangar Prashant Vihar are different. Prashant Vihar comes under West Delhi and Marvelangar comes in the South Delhi.
When the police took into possession this scooty, Was there any witness, public witness?
No, sir. There is no any public witness available that time.
Right. Any reason is given? Why the public witness was not called at the time of taking possession of the scooter?
Sir, because this is police doing investigation separately of this case, FIR 204 and 207. I think they called the independent witness or some other witness to also in that case. So in this case, they don't prosecution don't find it suitable to call that witness as PW.
Whether anything mentioned that investigating officer has tried somebody to join the investigation? In prosecution history, is it anything mentioned?
No, sir. It is not mentioned.
Nothing is mentioned.
No, sir.
Right. These are the two witnesses in the whole case. Public witness, one is complainant Pankaj, and other is eyewitness Vinod Kumar.
Yes, sir.
What this is, about the identity of the accused person.
So they say they managed to see the face of the complaint of the accused in their statement because the handkerchief they tied, the accused tied when they looting the articles, somehow the handkerchiefs were fell off. Was removed from the face of the both the accused. So they also mentioned the age of the accused is like 25 or 26 years and lean and slim.
As I came to know after going through FIR, they said that both the person had seen the accused person. And they can identify them if brought before them.
Yes, my lord.
This is what they says before the court. There are two questions: whether investigating officer during the investigation shown the accused person to the complainant as well as the eyewitness. Yes or no?
Pardon, my lord.
During the investigation. After taking custody, one thing is more: how much time? Whether the investigating officer move an application for police remand?
Sir, as they know about that, both the accused were arrested in the FIR 204 and 207.
All right. Thereafter, for his own case 157/90, the investigating officer has moved an application for police remand.
Yes, sir.
PC was first granted day. For how many days?
Sir, 4 days.
For 4 days.
Yes.
During these 4 days, whether the identification was done by the IO with the accused, complainant as well as eyewitness. Whether accused were shown to the complainant or eyewitness or not?
No, sir. Because IO moved the application for TIP, but the accused denied.
Despite that, I am asking the question. I had gone that through that application and the refusal of the TIP, but thereafter, after their refusal, IU has taken the police remand for 4 days. During this 4 days police remand, whether the IU has shows this two accused person to the complainant as well as the eyewitness Vinod Kumar?
No, sir.
Nothing is mentioned.
No.
All right. All right. What about all these things in the court? They identified in the court or not? Pankaj, complainant, as well as the eyewitness Vinod, they identified in the courtroom?
Sir, Pankaj cannot identify that, but Vinod did.
What Vinod said? Pankaj had not identified.
Yes, sir.
All right. What about Vinod?
So Vinod identified, but court says, sir, on page number 151 of the LCR.
Just.
Rishi, please come to page number 152 of the LCR. Pankaj says in this statement that there were three people who stopped our scooty and attacked Pankaj Kumar.
Just a minute. Is this a statement of Pankaj?
So this is the statement of eyewitness Vinod Kumar.
Vinod Kumar, all right.
Yes, sir. So in his statement, he mentioned that we reached Gitanjali Mark. There were three people who stopped our scooty and attacked Pankaj Kumar with the knife. Due to that, the scooty got imbalanced and I tried to handle it while the third person was carrying a gun and he shot me. I got unconscious that I opened my eyes in the hospital as I come took and took our statement.
In FIR, they said 2% stopped the scooty.
Yes, sir, but later on, They improve. Yes, sir. Because that time they were not conscious while giving the statement, but later on.
Where is the identification of the accused person?
Sir, on the page number, on the top of the page, here it is mentioned when court asked, can you recognize the accused? He stated, I cannot, but the learned judge at that time, he said that he cannot recognize the victim, but he was informed by them from the earlier witnesses. And this is the same point raised by the defense counsel. So he was saying that I can... The defense counsel raised the point that he was informed by other earlier witnesses.
He was informed by the by them from earlier witness. Why directly he had not identified the accused person? Though they were very much present in the courtroom.
Sir, because Learned Defense Counsel says that now he will say that I can identify because he definitely earlier witnesses said that these were the accused. So court marked this statement that I cannot recognize the victim.
Public prosecutors, kindly see your FIR 157, page number 16 of your challan.
Yes, my lord.
Kindly see the occurrence of offense, date Tuesday. And date from 9 to 9.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
Just yes, second line is 9 to 9, 22 to 2 hours.
Yes, yes, my lord.
What is this 2 hours?
Sir,
it was on 9th of?
No, sir, it was 10th of.
But it is right, 9th of?
Sir, the date is mentioned where the when the crime was committed occurred, and but this time
is given on 9th of September, is it right? I think it's a typographical mistake.
Yes, yes, my lord, I can say that this is a typographical mistake.
All right.
Because sir, in the point B, you say information received at PS. It is written 10 September 2019 and time was 2:15.
But I the down of this FIR, there is no delay in FIR. But I think some delay is also because 100 number had reached there within no time.
Yes,
and
sir.
The incident was incident what took place around, we can assume 10:15.
Yes, my lord.
But the police officer of police station says information was given on around 2:50.
Yes, my lord.
Around 5 hours later, or four.
Yes, my lord.
4.5 hours later.
Yes,
what is the distance of the police station from the place of incident?
Sir, 2 kilometers.
2 kilometers from the shop and police station is also 2 kilometers.
Yes, my lord.
All
addresses.
2 kilometers in night time, 2 kilometers is the distance of not more than 10 minutes by vehicle.
Yes, my lord.
There is no traffic. No, that is why the incident was took place. Since there was no traffic.
Yes, my lord.
So,
but sir,
why
the
take 5 hours? Is there,
sir,
any explanation given in the prosecution story?
No, my lord, but it would be like this. They made a PCR call. PCR call came there. It is also mentioned that 10 to 15 minutes later, PCR van came. And
right.
SI also reached the crime spot where he see that PCR van already taken away the victims to the AIMS. Then they go
how
to the
came
AIMS
to know that,
my lord.
How he came? How the investigating officer came to know that the PCR has brought the injured to the hospital?
Sir, is mentioned in the state in the brief facts of the charge sheet.
No, from the spot, when the investigating officer reach at the spot after 15, 10, half an hour, whatever it is, how he came to know that the injured were brought by the PCR to the hospital?
How he came sir, it is written in the brief. Sir, on page number 4 of the charge sheet, especially please on this page number 4, please scroll down. So it is written on 9 September 2019, SI Sachin along with Constable Suresh during emergency duty, DD number 07, dated 9 September, received an information by DD number 07, dated 9 September 2019, that in relation to Babatholi Chowk, Gitanjali Road, that the two boys by shooting a stab and snatched the scooty TVS Jupiter. And other articles like gold chain, gold rings, iPhone, cash, by pistol and knife, respectively. When SI along with Constable Suresh reached at the crime spot, there a lot of people were gathered and chaos all around. By asking around,
just hold down here. Whether he has taken any person from the pupils who were gathered at the place of incident as an witness?
No, sir. No, sir.
No witness.
Because there is no witness.
Any
that time, yes, my lord.
Whether he has issued any notice under section 108 to any person present at the spot?
No, my lord.
No, and no reason is given in the prosecution story.
No, ma'am.
All right.
That is written that they came to know that victims Mr. Pankaj Gupta and Vinod had already taken to the AIIMS Trauma Center in PCR van. SI along Constable Suresh reached the AIIMS Trauma Center where the complaints were being treated. So, my lordship, the delay you are talking about, it is all because of this. If they travel to the AIIMS Trauma Center and they are very not so close to the place of crime. They go and they waited for, well, they are become unconscious, then they will record the rukka. So that this is the reason of the delay. So after preparing the rukka, he given the rukka to the Constable Suresh and he take it to the PS and then the endorsement will
At what time he brought the rukka from the spot to the police station?
Sir, at 2:50, he brought rukka.
2:50.
Yes, my lord. And 2:57, FIR was printed. And SI Sikandar, this case handled to the SI Sikandar. So, or page number 20, the site of the manual charge sheet, this is a site plan of the crime spot. So this is the site plan of the crime spot.
Right.
Where mark A, if you see, is the mark A is the spot where crime was committed, Gitanjali Road, and then they run towards the holy chow. Rishi, please zoom.
I cannot hear you.
Your Honor, I'm audible to you now.
Now I do.
Sir, if you see point A, here is marked A, is the spot yes. where crime yes. was committed. Witnesses were there, Constable Suresh and complainant Pankaj Gupta.
Not audible. I cannot hear.
My lord.
It was not audible.
Your Honor, I'm audible now.
No audible.
Now I'm audible, my lord.
Yes.
So, sir, if you see the mark A, this is the spot of crime where crime was committed. And witnesses to this site plan are Constable Suresh and Complainant Pankaj Gupta. Rishi, please come to the page number 49 of the manual charge sheet. So this is the application which is moved by the IO seeking issuance of non-bailable warrant against the accused Mazhar Sattar, son of Abdul Sattar, because he was untraceable. And so, Rishi, please come to page number 58. So, this is the court order in where court granted the non-bailable warrant against the accused Mazhar Sattar. So, my lord, sir, if you.
What is this?
So it is requested before this honorable court that the accused persons are habitual offender and they have committed robbery, the offense under section 397, read with 326, 34, 120B, 482, 411 of IPC and 25, section 27, 29, 35 of the Arms Act against the victim number one and two, thereby with full planning and arrangements, they executed the robbery. The victim number one was an innocent who lost his belongings because of the person, accused person who have no moral and ethics of the life. It is further requested before this honorable court that the ingredients of this section 330, 397, 482, 411, 34, 326, 120B of the Indian Penal Code and 25, 27, 29, 35 of the Arms Act are duly satisfied against all the accused person. It is requested before this honorable court to take the matter with full caution and convict the accused persons under section 397, 482, 411, 34, 326, 120B of the Indian Penal Code and 25, 27, 29, 35 of the Arms Act and any other punishment accordingly, the court may deem fit.
All right. My last question.
Yes, my lordship.
Prosecutor, Mr. Prosecutor, is there any witness, public witness? I'm asking about the public witness. Public witness of arrest in other FIR. Any public witness of disclosure? Any public witness of recovery? Whether it is only scooty? The answer is no.
Yes, my lord.
All right. And is there any report given by the prosecution or the investigating officer for 4 days police remand? What they had done in the 4 days police remand? Is there anything, any separate report is mentioned in the challan?
Sir, there is no any separate report, but it is everything is mentioned in the DD entries. Sir, they mentioned every coming and going activities, where they disclose about the weapons, where they hide, and in the duration of the police custody, they seize the weapons like pistol, seize a 75B pistol.
Only weapon were recovered.
Yes.
Only sir. Weapon were recovered. Nothing else. Other than the weapon, nothing. Is there any public witness of recovery of weapon?
Sir, witness. Witnesses are constables, Shurais.
I'm asking prosecutor about the public witness.
Sir, there is no public witness, or accused are also there. Only witnesses, accused and constable Shurais.
Constable Shurais and
accused Jahid Khan and Rohit Verma. These are the witnesses.
But no public witness of finding out and the recovery.
Yes, my lord.
What was the place of recovery?
Sir, place of recovery is mentioned in the disclosure statement, which is by page number 79. Rishi, please come to the page number 79. This is the disclosure statement by accused Jahid Khan. In case FIR number 157.
Right.
Sir, Rishi, please come to page number 80.
Yes.
And please scroll down. Sir, here it is clearly written that we went to our sacred place where we distribute the robbed material equally and spent it.
It is from line?
Sir, from the last line, second last line.
Second last line, yes.
After committing the offense, they came to their secret place where he distributed the robbed material equally and spent it. So it is the reason why police didn't recover the stolen articles, because they sell it.
They went to our secret place where we distributed the robbed material equally and spent. All right. I'm asking about the scooty. The scooty was recovered from which place?
Kadambari Road.
Kadambari Road. But yes, there was no public witness.
No, sir.
What was the position of that place?
Sir, the scooty was recovered under FIR 204.
All right. I'm asking whether any public witness was cited regarding the recovery of the scooty? No.
Sir, I think it might be cited, but in this case, case number 157, prosecution felt that it is no relevancy to bring that witness because it was the part of that investigation which was carrying forward on under 204, FIR 204.
No, scooty was the subject matter of this present FIR 157. All right, nothing is. All right.
And sir, that day when prosecution evidence was conducted, prosecution comes with many witnesses, but the learned judge allows only five witnesses by asking the authenticities and the relevancies to this case. So he only
permitted five witnesses. How many witnesses cited?
Sir, if you... Sir, 11 witnesses were cited. Rishi, please come on page number 3. Page number 3 of the charge sheet. This is the list of the witnesses. 11 persons are there, but a learned judge on stage of prosecution witnesses allows only five witnesses.
But in the whole list,
yes, sir,
cited by the prosecution, I think, yes, there is no other public witness except the Pankaj Gupta and the Vinod Kumar. Complainant, as well as one eyewitness.
Sir, not the independent witness, but there is a witness that MHCM CP PS Prashant Vihar to prove case property seized in FIR 204 PS Prashant Vihar on 7 number.
He is MHCM. He is a police officer. He is police officer. He is from the police station. I am asking about the public witness.
Yes, sir.
He is not independent. Sir, he is the witness of prosecution. He is your witness. All right. No problem. Very good. Can you hear me?
Sir, the role of this witness is... Yes, my lord.
I'm not hearing.
I'm audible to you now.
Now audible.
My lord, I'm audible. So, Your Honor, no. If you see the role of the witness is to prove the case property. Am I audible, my lord?
Yes.
But the role of this witness, MHCM CP Prashant Vihar, to prove case property seized in FIR 204, PS Prashant Vihar. But the motive is to prove the case property seized in FIR. But... learned judge that day did not allow him. He only allowed five witnesses, which was relevant to case FIR 157.
But he was not the public. He was the witness of prosecution. He was,
yes, my lord,
from your office.
He was a witness.
All right.
Yes.
Very, very good. Very nice. Maxim helping hand. Thank you very much. Public prosecutor. Now, defense counsel is here. Yes, defense counsel.
Your Lordship, am I audible?
Yes, now audible.
Counsel seeks permission to proceed. Your Lordship,
yes.
Your Lordship, the work of defense counsel.
Just a minute. Yes.
Your Lordship, the work of defense counsel is to put an iota of doubt in the case, but here the counsel from the side of defense will be putting number of doubts in this case and will substantiate the same with the case.
There is some connectivity problem. I'm
not
hearing. It's
a simple implanted fabricated single page without contradiction. Every single doubt. Am I audible, Your Lordship?
No.
Your Lordship, am I audible?
Just a minute. Yes, continue.
Your Lordship, every single page of the charge sheet has inconsistencies leading to certain doubts. The prosecution has not proved anything at all beyond reasonable doubt. And to prove this and to make this case crystal clear, counsel will start by showing first that what they have done and how it is the waste of court's precious time. Your Lordship, starting with the crime scene investigation, which is the purpose of which is to establish what happened, that is crime scene reconstruction, and to identify responsible person. This has to be done cautiously by documenting the conditions at the crime scene and recognizing all relevant physical evidences. However, we can see the sincerity of the IO in this case, who is himself accepting that he left straight to the hospital to see the complainant, leaving the crime scene, which was crowded and full of chaos, without any investigation. Also, there is no evidence on record to show that he sealed that area or waited for any police official to arrive, providing enough opportunity for tampering with the evidences, if any. Even there are contradictory statements regarding the site map as well, Your Lordship. On page 23, it is provided that which police is claiming that was
just wait. I'm not hearing.
Was prepared in front of the complainant on 10th September, that he got discharged from the hospital on 16th itself.
Yes.
Your Lordship, in the MLC reports of the complainant provided on page 24, we can see that he got discharged on 16 September. Also, Your Lordship, they are themselves confirming throughout the trial that in a crowded area, they failed in managing any witness to the incident. In fact, even the CCTV camera of that area, they got nothing, which is squaring the circle, as in a crowded place, someone committed a robbery, a person got shot in a... But not even a single person saw this happening. Even the CCTVs didn't capture anything. Further, the work for which a team of forensic experts with specialized toolkits...
Was there any CCTV in range? Was there any CCTV in range?
Can you please... Indeed, Your Lordship, police is itself accepting in the cross that they saw the CCTV of that area but got nothing. It is provided on page 154 of the MLC.
Page 54.
Of the LCI, Your Lordship.
Yes.
Your Lordship, further, the work for which a team of forensic experts with specialized toolkits are required. The IO managed to do it himself. On page 68, Your Lordship, we can see that he sees, when he came back to the crime scene, he sees the bullet and blood stains. Also, same goes with the gun and the, as per Punjab police guidance. Also, after seizing all these evidences in absence of any independent witness, he handed it over to Constable Suresh, who was supposed to take all these evidences to Malkhana. But again, there is no evidence or storeroom register to prove it. Also, Your Lordship, Constable Suresh, who in spite of having his name mentioned at almost every single point as the only witness, didn't sign any document at first place. Also, Your Lordship, when he was supposed to appear as PW9 from the prosecution side, he never showed up. Shows the broken chain of custody, which is a matter of grave concern. This also creates a serious doubt about admissibility.
Just wait. Who is PW9?
Constable Suresh, Your Lordship.
Page number?
Page number 6 of the LCR. Also, Your Lordship, there is no application or anything to prove that the learned judge didn't allow these prosecution witnesses.
Prosecution has deleted his name from the list.
Your Lordship, this person never showed up in the court when it was the time to testify.
All right.
Not only this, Your Lordship, but coming to the confession of my clients to the police, which has although no relevance as per Section 25 of Indian Evidence Act, except for the part leading to any substantive recovery of evidences under Section 27, which is the gun and the knife in instant case. Your Lordship, during the cross-examination of the IO, we can see on page 155 of the LCR, he's admitting that after the complaint, he recovered these weapons from the crime scene itself.
155?
This makes this disclosure completely useless. Indeed, Your Lordship.
Page 155?
Indeed, Your Lordship. This makes this disclosure completely useless because till that time, they didn't even caught the accused. Coming to the point out memo and seizure memos, Your Lordship, my clients never signed any such document. We can see on page 70 and 71 of the LCR. In fact, no independent witness ever signed these documents. All these are again showing that this is a botched case. In arguendo, even if the evidences are not implanted, then also it is not going to favor the prosecution in any way, as they not only failed in proving that my clients used these weapons, but they also failed in showing that these weapons were even used in committing the crime. As the police is accepting on page 155 of the LCR, the fact that there were no blood found on the weapons, these weapons were never shown to the complainant for identification, and not even to the doctor to confirm whether similar injuries can be sustained by these weapons or not. Your Lordship, not only this, but as per the report, please refer to page 136 of LCR. Multiple knife, we can clearly see here.
136.
Whereas during the cross examination, indeed, Your Lordship, the knife was a foldable. During the cross-examination of expert witness, PW5, provided on page 157. Page 157 of LCR. Yeah? He confirmed that the knife used was a normal knife.
Yes.
Your Lordship, am I audible?
Yes.
He is also confirming the fact that he received these evidences on 10th September 2019 itself. But Your Lordship, my clients got arrested on 3rd October 2019. That is the next month. Clears that there is no discovery of weapons through my clients. Your Lordship?
What does mean of normal weapon?
Your Lordship, the knife, the type of the knife which was used, as per the witness, as per the expert witness, he is stating that the knife he received was a normal knife, whereas police is claiming, that the knife which they seized was a foldable knife.
Foldable knife is also normal knife.
Your Lordship, type of, if we ask to expert witness that what type of a knife it is clear that foldable knife doesn't comes under normal knife. Normal knife doesn't fold, Your Lordship.
That is called churi. All right.
Your Lordship, prosecution doesn't even have a straight story with regard to what happened and how it happened. The complainant of the case, in his 164 statement to the court, provided on page 107 of LCR, he's disposing that during snatching, only the boy with the gun robbed his handkerchief. Whereas to the contrary, in his in-chief, he's stating the in-chief is provided on page 149 of the LCR. He's stating that during snatching, the boy with knife robbed his handkerchief. Also in his in-chief, he's stating that there were two people who attacked and then he identified them. And till the time of cross, the number is 3 and he is not even able to recognize the accused presented in court. In Munshi Singh Gautam versus State of Madhya Pradesh, the Honorable Supreme Court held that test identification parade doesn't constitute substantive evidence, but substantive evidence is the evidence of identification in court itself. The fact that complainant failed in it challenges his credibility. Further, in the testimony of PW3, Mr. Vinod Kumar, that is provided on page 152, Your Lordship. Your Lordship, he is stating that 3 people attacked him with knife and third person shot him with the gun. Whereas to the contrary, in his 164 statement and also in the statement of complainant, they both are disposing that the third one was just standing with the bike at quite a distance and second one shot him. Further, Your Lordship, even he was not able to recognize any of the accused presented in the court. As per number of judgments, the principle is that a witness who makes inconsistent statements is unreliable and his evidences should be ignored, Your Lordship. In fact, the case is prima facie appearing fabricated as there is not even a single ground to believe that my clients committed any offense. Even the genuineness of the FIR is contested as, Your Lordship, the complainant never signed the FIR. This observation was also made by the court, provided on page 146, Your Lordship, of the LCR. They are not even able to manage a single page without contradiction, as we can see on page 89, Your Lordship, 89 of the LCR, that is the panchnama of the scooty, that for a same document, in the start, they are mentioning 2 dates. In the start, it is 8th October, and till the end of the document, it is 6th October. Also, Your Lordship, if we'll refer to the FIRs of other cases which prosecution is claiming, in which the prosecution is claiming the involvement of my clients, although they failed in providing any concrete evidence to prove it, as we can see, Your Lordship, that the IO who was able to prove these evidences in front of court never showed up as the only witness, Your Lordship. Further, the IO during itself on page 155 of the LCR is admitting that the only reason he got the complaint of the complainant about my clients. Your Lordship, the description of a person provided by who's himself not able to identify the person he's describing. Also, we can see that these FIRs, if you'll refer to page 31 of the LCR, the complaint of case 204, and then we'll see, and then after, if we'll see the complaint of this case, they are having exactly the same situation as that of the incident. Your Lordship, for a prudent man, it is still acceptable that in all the cases, one is holding knife and one is holding gun. It might be their modus operandi, but the peculiar events of handkerchief falling off from the face at exactly same time, or that they being attacked exactly at 10 p.m. in every case, is nothing but a groundhog day for them, maybe. Your Lordship, These cases are exactly identical, shows that the complainants of the FIRs were tutored, and it is an acutely fabricated case. Moving further to the testimony of Dr. Your Lordship, PW2, provided on page 151. Your Lordship, this doctor is claiming in MLC reports the nature of injury sustained by victims as grave and dangerous. He is not even able to tell the meaning of these words during the testimony, Your Lordship, in front of court. Your Lordship, in Manu Sharma versus State, it was held by Honorable Supreme Court that under Section 45 of Indian Evidence Act, an expert is an expert only if he follows well-accepted guidelines to arrive at a conclusion and supports same with logical reasoning. But Your Lordship, in instant case, the fact that doctor is not able to tell whether the victim got shot from front or back creates a serious question on his credibility. Also, Your Lordship, especially for a surgeon, it is a basic thing to identify entry and exit wound of the bullet just by having a mere glance. That too in this case, where there is not even an exit wound, as the bullet was recovered from within the body of the victim. This also shows that this person never met the victims. Otherwise, he would have definitely know about this. Treating them is again squaring a circle. Your Lordship, right to fair trial, presumption of innocence unless proven guilty, and proof of prosecution's case beyond any reasonable doubt are the fundamentals of our jurisprudence. Clearly, beyond reasonable doubt, as at first, no present circumstantial evidences. They didn't. Your Lordship, now am I audible?
No audible.
Your Lordship, at first, Your Lordship, as at first, they didn't provide any concrete evidence to present the case. Also, to present the circumstantial evidences, they didn't follow the prescribing conditions. It is such a botched case, Your Lordship, that at every stage and step, we are getting contradictory statements, which they are themselves providing. Your Lordship, prima facie case appears as fabricated. Therefore, it is a humble request of counsel from defense for an immediate and honorable acquittal of my clients under Section 235 of CIPC and provide justice. I'm grateful, Your Lordship.
What about recovery of his scooty?
Your Lordship, we can see that on page. Your Lordship, there is no
evidence. Just it is not audible.
Anything else on record to prove the same that the. Your Lordship, there is nothing on record to show. Am I audible?
Not audible. Just wait.
Your Lordship, on indeed.
It is not clearly audible.
Your Lordship, on page 89 of the LCR, we can see that for a panchnama they are claiming. Am I audible, Your Lordship, now? Hello. Your Lordship, am I audible? Hello?
Yes, now audible.
Your Lordship, they didn't provide any document to prove the same. Also, Your Lordship, the only panchnama they are claiming as the only record, we can see in that panchnama provided on page 89 that they're not even sure about the date of this document. Such tentative document cannot be relied, Your Lordship.
Yes. What about the fingerprints found on weapons?
Your Lordship, for the fingerprints itself, further, there is no application to show that any fingerprint was ever sent for the FSL or record to show that they ever taken any fingerprints of my clients. Also, Your Lordship. if you talk about the fingerprints, the expert witness in his statement is stating that the fingerprints were found, whereas throughout the charge sheet, they're claiming that the first one used the gun, Your Lordship. Again, there is a contradiction that the person who never hold that gun, his fingerprints are on the gun, Your Lordship.
What about the matching of cap found from the spot and the bullet from the body from hospital and the pistol?
Your Lordship, coming to that point, Your Lordship. Your Lordship, on page 68, we can see that bullet cap was, not on page 68, Your Lordship. Just provide a second. Your Lordship, on page 20, the doctor is stating that bullet was taken out and was directly sent to forensic department, Your Lordship. Police is not even in the picture. But Your Lordship, police is claiming that they seized the bullet, Your Lordship, again showing broken chain of custody.
Doctor says this was that the forensic expert says that this is the same bullet cap and used in the pistol.
Indeed, Your Lordship, but this they have nothing to show that my clients used this or this was even used in the crime, Your Lordship, as there is broken chain of all the evidences, Your Lordship. Broken chain of custody.
You mean there was no public witness of recovery?
Indeed, Your Lordship. Further, they're not even sure that who sent these report, the bullet, to the forensic. The doctor is claiming that they sent it. The police is claiming that no, we seized this bullet.
What about the blood found?
There was no blood found on the weapons, Your Lordship. They're themselves accepting the fact.
And fingerprints on the weapons?
You're not audible.
Fingerprints on
weapons? Your Lordship, first, there was no fingerprint. Your Lordship, first, there was no fingerprint on one weapon, and the second weapon, which again contradicting themselves, that on one hand they're saying that Zahid was holding the gun, on the other hand they're saying that Rohit's fingerprints were on it. Also, Your Lordship, there is no evidence.
No, it is not audible.
That fingerprints were, even the fingerprints of my clients were even taken.
Just wait, it is not audible. You kindly check your connection. It is not audible.
It is due to weather. Your Lordship, am I audible?
There is some problem in the connectivity.
Indeed,
sir. So can we switch out the video of the participants so the audio can be connected properly?
Your Lordship, am I audible now?
No audible.
Your Lordship, there is not even an evidence to show that fingerprints were ever taken of my clients. How can they send something which has not even taken by them? Or nothing to show that these fingerprints which they are telling that found on the gun matched with my clients. They are mentioning the accused persons, but also on other hand, they are stating that only one fingerprint was found. Also, they are not even sure about which person's fingerprints it was.
Why you refuse the TIP?
Your Lordship, my TIP in this case has no relevance, as they are claiming by themselves that the complainant saw the accused persons already. Also, Your Lordship, doesn't denying for TIP doesn't constitute anything against the clients, as it is not in substantial piece of evidence, Your Lordship. And the fact that complainants...
When you refuse the TIP,
can you repeat the question?
When you refuse the TIP in the court, have you given any reason that you have already shown to? Yes.
Your Lordship, the reason is that it is an implanted case, and my clients were of the fear that if TIP took place, they'll be in more difficult situation.
Whether you have mentioned the reason or not, when you refused the TIP before the court, as you are putting today,
yes, Your Lordship, the reason was given by my clients.
Already shown to the witness. You had already shown to the witnesses, all right. But whether you have same you have mentioned before the court the day of refusal?
Your Lordship, we can see this on record, the observation made. In just a minute, Your Lordship. Your Lordship, it is under court observation itself.
All right. No, you have not mentioned the reason why you are refusing the TIP.
Your Lordship, the reason was provided at the time of observation.
All right.
Also, the fact, Your Lordship, that complainants were not even able to identify my clients in front of the court.
All right. Do you want to submit any judgment, both the side, prosecution side as well as you defense counsel?
Indeed, Your Lordship, multiple judgments are there. If the court
today you want to submit something
permits, I would like to show the same. Indeed, Your Lordship. Your Lordship, the very first judgment which counsel likes to submit is Vijay Singh and others versus State of UP. Your Lordship. This judgment says that, Your Lordship, the burden of proving the case beyond reasonable doubt is always on the prosecution and never shifts, Your Lordship. And innocent unless proven guilty by the prosecution is our fundamental of criminal jurisprudence, Your Lordship. Also, Your Lordship, in Manu Sharma versus State NCT, it is held that credibility of these witnesses was challenged only, and case diary can only be used as aid in inquiry or trial, but not as evidence. In this case, they have nothing except the case diary to show anything, Your Lordship.
All right. Mr. Public Prosecutor? Is it audible?
Yes, my lord, I'm audible to you.
Yes.
So, as...
Any rebuttal?
Of course, my lord. Of course. So, my lord...
Only 2 minutes. What is the time now?
So, my lord...
Can you brief in very short, within 2-3 minutes?
Yes, my lord.
If any rebuttal.
I will take only 2 minutes.
Number one, would you like to submit some judgment in your favor?
No, my lord.
All right.
So, my lord, as a learned defense counsel, bring out some points that I want to argue on that. That number first point, he said the crowded area. So, my lordship, as per the prosecution story, the crowd assembled after the occurrence of the crime, not during the. So as the scenario, police asked from the public, but they denied because it is a natural law. Always they try to keep themselves separated from the investigation. And talking about the CCTV footages, as I already mentioned, that there is no CCTV footage at the crime spot.
When anybody denied for the statement, it was the duty of the investigating officer to issue the notice to him after noting all his whereabout, name, father name, address, and issue a notice under section 108 CRPC. Whether it was done by the IE or not, it was not done.
But about CCTV? Sir, CCTV footage, my lord, there is no CCTV footage at the crime spot. There are CCTV footage at the area, not in the crime spot. So how they will find something? And sir, they are talking about Constable Suresh presents. So as I already told to this court, that police prosecution bring him as a public witness. But that day, learned judge did not allow him because they only allow 5 witnesses. He asked public prosecutor to choose only 5 competent witnesses. So I choose only them, 5 witnesses which I allowed. So this is not that ki prosecution did not bring him and present him as PW. Prosecution did, but learned judge disallowed him. And secondly, relevancy, and they asked relevancy of weapons. That they are saying that they are not relevant weapons, but in FSL report, it is clearly mentioned that fingerprints are matches to the with the weapon and they recovered from the accused places. And the third reason is contradiction of Pankaj Gupta. But my lordship, there the statement of the victim Pankaj Gupta is clearly keep on saying it. They are involved.
Just a minute, public prosecutor.
Yes, my
lordship. Whether the weapon, knife as well as the pistol, sent to the FSL earlier than the arrest or after their arrest?
Sir, of course, after the arrest. If you see and come to the page number. Rishi, please come to the page number 157 of the LCR. Yeah. So it is the place, sir, if you see the question where the learned defense counsel referred that when you received the evidence, sir, here it is not mentioned where you received the weapon, only evidence. So FSL accepting the evidences from the date of the incident, like bullet and bullet cap. These are also evidences. So in this question, the PW5, Dr. V.V. Sachana referred to those evidences, not to the weapons. And the contradiction of dates, learned defenses referred that only prosecution have the proof of panchanama. So I like to say that it is not on record. It is not exhibited. But still, if learned defense counsel wants to argue on that, so I want to bring some things in light. Please come to the page number 86. So, 86 of the... Yes. So, my lordship, as the learned defense counsel raised the contradiction of dates. So, the date is mentioned above 10th 9. So, it is the date of FIR is mentioned. The police is referring to the case FIR number 157 dated 10th September 2019. And the date of where the panchanama was held is 8th October. So, it is not any contradiction on dates. So, and again, but, my lordship. Yes, my lord.
What about the other contradiction, like a complainant Pankaj Gupta says, I know the eyewitness Vinod Kumar since 4-5 years. But the Vinod Kumar says in his statement, I know the Pankaj Gupta since last 3-4 months.
Because, my lordship, Vinod Kumar refers to the tenure of his employment. He was working from the four five months, but Pankaj Gupta known him from many years ago. That's he gave the opportunity to work as servant under him.
The question put by the council was same. Since what time you know to each other?
Yes, my lord.
He says 4-5 years, and Vinod Kumar says 5-6 months. All right. No problem. Any other rebuttal?
Yes, my lord. If you allow me for 1 second, I will show one rebuttable in this.
Right. Tell me.
And my lordship, as Learned Defense Council referred to many judgments, but he didn't submit to the court before. So how can she refer to this point?
All right.
Your lordship, just a point to make.
Please.
Your lordship, everything which prosecution is saying is they are deliberately misleading the court. As for first of all, your lordship, they have nothing to, no evidence on record to show that whatever they are saying are true. And your lordship, this court accepts nothing but the evidences. Apart from the evidences, nothing is acceptable, your lordship. And they don't have any.
But all right. Prosecution is giving his evidences, my lord, to the point.
Very nice. All right. Chaliye, thank you very much. I noted down everything, and
thank you so much, sir.
I will give the result. Wish you all the best. Both of you have done very well.
Thank you, sir.
Very nice.
Registry, you have anything to say to sir? Laksh?
Yes, sir.
Do you want to communicate something to sir?
No, sir.
Okay, sir will complete the evaluation and will send through mail?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Rupesh, sir?
I will do that. Inshallah, I will do that.
To sir?
Yes, sir. So I would like to thank sir for giving his time and judging this round and for giving your valuable feedback to our participants. And I hope that that will definitely help them when they will go to real court. And it was point-wise discussion where you have given your opinion as well. So I wish that not only participant, but all the other audience who have joined, they will learn something from it. Thank you so much, sir,
thank you
for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I am personally obliged. You call me and invite. Thank you.
Thank you for your presence, sir.
My lordship.
Thank you.
My lordship. Am I audible to you?
Yes.
My lordship, as you asked me to quote some judgment, so I'd like to bring one judgment in my in favor of my case.
Public prosecutor, the session is over already.
Over now. Okay.
Session is over. If you want to send it on, send it on my mail. If you are having the mail.
But all depends upon judgeship. If he will allow, everything is permissible.
Right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Public prosecutor, kindly send the kindly send the cases through mail to honorable judge.
Okay, sir.
Sir, thank you so much for your time today.
सर बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, जजाक अल्लाह खैर. मैं अभी आपसे दो चार मिनट बात करता लेकिन इजाजत ले रहा हूँ, नमाज जमात का वक्त हो गया.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल,
तो इंशाल्लाह मैं फिर फोन पे बात करूंगा.
फोन पे बात कर लेंगे.
जजाक अल्लाह खैर, बेहद शुक्रिया.
विद योर परमिशन कैन वी एंड द सेशन सर?
यस ऑन.
ओके, थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू सर.